Is there space to drive in here?
Stop.
Thank you.
SCRO. SCRO, don't you?
Before we commence, I have always supported women. I am for women. I love women. Over 70% of our voters are women. On this table, this high table, it cannot be a high table without a woman. In this effect, I would like to call on a woman that I respect so much. And we have the same ideology. Someone I believe deserves a seat on this high table. As you are there, please take your seat. Please give her a round of applause as she walks. I believe one woman won't just do. We need more. I would like to praise her and on Grace Adigo to also join us at the high table. Yes, she's very charismatic. Sorry, before I hand over to the Master of Ceremony, I would like to share a few thoughts of mine, just a few minutes. For those of you that only understand Hausa language, I will try as much as possible to translate whatever I'm about to say. For so long, we have observed the political space. We have gone through a lot of difficulties. I can start by saying I grew up in a neighborhood called Tugumbala. I had Christians, Muslims. I didn't know if someone was a Yoruba man, an Igbo man, an ethnic, Hausa, Fulani. I knew nothing of that sort. We had mosques and churches side by side. There was no segregation of any sort. So I grew up a happy child. I didn't know anything about religious violence. We had no politicians then. Then in 1999, we decided to start politics. After 1999, they came in and they started dividing us between ethnic and religious lines. Those of you that know me know that I'm not a religious bigot. I am a Muslim, but I also have Christian brothers, friends, and Malaysians. It is time for us to unify Kaduna once more. Politicians have done a great havoc, and here we have a friend. I followed Sahara reporters for a very long time. I've been a critic of previous governments, and today I stand behind Sowere. 101%. And I believe that it's time we put aside sentiment in politics. Pick someone that will respect your religion, let you practice your religion, and provide good governance. That is what we want. I will pick a person I feel deserves to be the president, not based on ethnic or religious lines, but based on patriotism. Those of you that know me know I stand for truth and justice. Mutanena, we are with you. Munde da muna magana siyasa. Munde da muna ganin yanda ɗan siyasa suka fada mana kasan. Sanda nake yawo na san masallaci da coci da gidan giya duk suna wajen layi da a tunin wara fa. Sannan ɗan siyasa suka zo. Suka fara nuna mana wannan musulmi ne, wannan ba musulmi ba ne. Wannan ba nufe ne, wannan kaza ne. Suka raba mu domin our strength. Ƙarfinmu is our number. Ƙarfinmu yawanmu. Nan Arewa House ne. And I'm very sure that we are not just Muslims here or Christians here, but one Nigeria. Kujan da zuciyar ku ku zaɓi mutum da zai mana adalci a wanda zai zo mana ƙarya ba ya ce shi wani musulmi ne sannan ya bamu cikin talauci idan mutum zai baka ka yi practicin addininka ka je masallaci ka je church kai ko shirin da ke da shi in zai baka ka je ya baka healthcare ya baka education ya baka hanyoyi ya baka employment matan mu suna wahala gender balance din nan da ake magana ba sa mana adalci idan za a yi mana to wallahi wallahi Allah ya sa baya da addini ina tare da shi insha Allah. I'd like to call on the master of ceremony to take off from here and give a befitting welcome to my friend, to my brother and my mentor, Omoyele Sowore.
Yes. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. You are all welcome to this historic event, Kaduna Town Hall meeting, to during which we are going to be looking at the person of Omoyele Sowore, who is bringing his, humbling himself and bringing himself to you today so that you know him better. And then in the course of the meeting, the town hall meeting, there will be interaction. You will have questions to ask and then he will give you answers. So that his plans, his visions, and his agenda for the country, for you and I, to get for Nigeria to be a better place. You'll be able to hear for yourself one-on-one. I'm sure some of us have been seeing him on social media, we have been seeing him on TV, but today he's here in person. He has brought himself all the way from his busy schedule to come and be with you today. So please and please and please, We want to appreciate everybody who is here. We want to appreciate your time. We value your time and we appreciate you making out your busy schedule to be here. Please, we want us to be very orderly in the course of the 2 hours we are going to be here. So that everybody that has one something to say, we will see it and then you hear from the person of the moment. We thank you very much for your coming and your patriotism. Nigeria is for all of us. No, there's nobody that is more a Nigerian than another person. If it is good, if Nigeria is good, it's good for everybody. If it is not good, then all of us, we are going to suffer it, but we hope that it will be better than it is. So thank you very much for coming. We'll take the event as it goes. Thank you very much.
At this juncture, can we all please rise for the national anthem? The Nigerian national anthem.
And I have the distinguished honor of calling upon my Mr. Dogo for a very brief welcome address.
Yeah, hello. Are we together?
Yes.
Thank you very much. But first and foremost, before I start talking, I want to know whether you are happy to be in this very hall today. Can you walk and shake 4 people that you are welcome to this town hall meeting? I'll be very glad. All of us should get up. Shake 4 persons and say you are welcome to this very event. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. I am overwhelmed. It's alright. It's alright. It's alright. So it's okay, everybody back to your seat.
Back to your seat, please, back to your seat. Back to your seat, please.
The ladies and gentlemen, I appreciate for honoring this very line and gentleman. First and foremost, the second aspect is this. Tell yourself that I've committed my brief remarks to be goes like this. The notice was short.
But since I'm part of the circle, I said that I have to come and show concern and support. Thank you very much. Can you take your seat? Take your seat. Please take your seat. Take your seat. My amazing youthful compatriots, ladies and gentlemen. Today is a good day that we need to thank our almighty creator for bringing us together at this very mighty time, in that we'll be able to put things straight to the betterment of our lives. You see, the forum today is nothing but I call it youth demand for battle of leadership. Youth demand for battle of leadership. The word youthfulness shall be seen and practicalized today on this very great meeting of ours. Nothing else but automatically, we all speak with one voice, which I know without any doubt emanating from any quarter. This meeting in Kaduna Hall today, specifically Ari House, will kickstart what I see and observe. I call it youthful slogans for the betterment of Federal Republic of Nigeria. Well, as we can all see, your political strategies and leaders under one umbrella have piloted and discussed political settings. Good settings, I call. And that should be seen moving towards our collective political goal. Today in Nigeria, there is long outstanding issues that border many of us. Issues that really touch heart and humanity. What are those issues? We tend to say, yes, it is our time. But what have we seen in this very hall today have shown practically that the youth of Federal Republic of Nigeria have made a good decision to come into the political scene. I know a lot have been said before me, but the truth has to be spoken. With what we have gathered or what we have seen, I will be convinced beyond reasonable doubt that yes, with this push, with this togetherness, with this collective effort, we shall all get to the promised land. Ladies and gentlemen, I am overwhelmed. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Barrister, for your welcome answer. We'll go straight to the point now. Right. Yes. The person for whom we are here today, I'll just give you a brief, just a skeletal rundown of who he is. We all know him as the chief spokesperson of the Sahara Reporters. Apart from that, I want you to know that he's a person of vision, a very matured person by his actions and by the things he has achieved in life. And also, he's a person that is going to take us, bring the youth, most especially, to the promised land. So, just to name a few of his achievements, he's a lecturer in the university, abroad, and he has been into a lot of humanitarian activities both within the country and outside the country. So I have this privilege and the honor to introduce to you no other person than Omoyele.
Good evening, Kaduna. I thank you tonight for your love, your support and your enthusiasm so that by 2019 we will have a different Nigeria. When I walked into this room and I saw a lot of our sisters and mothers, great ladies, I said to myself, there are some times in life that you have to be careful so that you are not tempted. Tonight, I am very, very tempted to just say, I love you all. From the bottom of my heart. And we have just returned from Kano. Kano is almost 4 hours from here, but it should have been less than 1.5 hours. I have an interpreter who is going to speak in Hausa. Me, Dan Jolani, but I'm just coming from Kano. So me, Dan Kano. Ama, right now, me, Dan Kaduna. Go back, Ama. So, we just came from Kano. And the journey should have been about 1.5 hours or 2 hours maximum. But it took us almost 3.5 hours to go and another 3 hours to come back. But I decided that I'm not going to fly to Kano, I will travel by road to Kano. Because the other candidates in this election that we are fighting in 2019, they are too afraid to travel on our road. Because me, I am not afraid of the North, because I did my NYC in the North. So when we come to Tango, we went to a radio station. And at the radio station, one engineer called in and said, I told him, I said, nobody could fix Kano Kaduna Road for 3 years. Oh, he said, oh, it is not like that. We have just awarded the contract to Julius Berger. When we were coming, I was looking for Julius Berger on the road. No Julius Berger on the road. No bad road. The truth is that they have lied to us for too long. They use religion to lie to us. They use ethnicity to lie to us. They have used their class, the fact that we are poor, to lie to us. They have lied to us for so long. Can you listen to me, please? They have lied to us for so long that me, I don't call them presidents or senators or governors anymore. I call them what Hausa people call Munafiki Banza. And the ones that are not liars, they are thieves. We call them Barau Banza. But now we are saying bye bye to all the Munafiki, the Barau people, and all the politicians that have put up with this.
government in 2019 that it will not take more than 3 months to construct the road from Kano to Kaduna. Government is that as you go, but that's a picture when you go and look at you, but that has a tenant and the tunnel who are Kaduna. Chicken Karamon look at you, but I mean, when a mummy say, hi, ya, kai, chenji, chicken, I'm much more than the money one. We will bring about a government that will bring about unity in this Kaduna, so that there will no longer be southern or northern Kaduna, but happy Kaduna.
Babu wani magana kabilanci, babu wani magana addini, babu wani magana babba, babu wani magana uban gida, ko yaro gida, ko yarinyar gida. Kasan nan namu ne kuma za mu ta duka ne da yarinya take.
When we were coming here, when we started this, they said we cannot go to Kano, that you dare not go to Kano because it's President Buhari's home. We came to Kano, we went there today, we went to see the emir. People were hailing us on the streets.
Abin dariya da muke zaka ce ba za mu iya zuwa Kano ba wai da mun kasan bari ne muka ce a'a. To mun je Kano ko mun isa lafiya ko mun je har gurin sarki kuma ya ashe mu da hannu. Saboda haka
when we started they said we cannot come to Kaduna, we cannot leave Lagos. We are in Kaduna tonight. And Kaduna, Lagos, Port Harcourt, Benin, Naibawa to Rumokoro, every part of Nigeria must be free.
Lagos.
Let me address quickly the issue of women empowerment, because there are a lot of women here tonight. You know that Nigeria would never have become an independent country if women did not play an active role in fighting for independence. But every time we get the liberation we need, women are always asked to go to the kitchen. And our Baba, when he was in London, he said women belong to the kitchen, in the parlor, and the other room. No, we are bringing women to the parlor. When we take over power on May 29, 2019.
Inshallah, on May 29, 2019,
we are going to constitute a cabinet of 50-50. 50% women, 50% men. There will be a lot of empowerment for women, but healthcare is also very important. Our women must enjoy universal health care. And people ask me all the time when I make promises, like, how are you going to pay for it? All of you know that Nigeria has money. We have plenty of money. But it has never gone to the Nigerian people. It has always gone to a cabal, a few people. And we are going to take it and give it to the Nigerian people for health care. So what I say, if you ever
magana sai a ce daga ina zai samu wannan kudin ne sai duba ya dariya muka ce menene Nigeria muna da kasa ko haiki karfi zabi yawanmu ya kishe mu kai gaban mu kai kasa mu inda ya kamata mu kai shi saboda haka abinda muke da shi a kasa da shi zamu amfani mu bunkasa kasan mu.
We are also going to make sure that our sisters and mothers and ladies enjoy massive employment because we are going to turn Nigeria into a construction site. We are going to make loans available for small businesses so that people can do trades that they want to do. They can prosper and make their children go to school whenever necessary, pay for healthcare, even be able to go on vacation that they have never gone to in a long time. Please, one house, please. This one house. We want to make sure that we don't start behaving like the old politicians. When I came here, I did not come here to distribute pure water, Coca-Cola or Gala.
We are not here to make trouble. 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 We
I came here with an idea to liberate this country from the shackles of oppression that has lasted for 58 years. And I don't want us to be distracted by food. Just let's wait to 2019, there will be plenty of food, plenty of drink in this country.
For the 58th year, Shetara has seen the noise now. I've seen the tumbles. Nigeria is a winner. Ana magana daya to yanzu mun ga mun kana kuma mun zo da manufa daya so sai da haka da kamata a ce an ne mun da ake raba ba ko dan wani akan ne zaka ci zai zo ya canza manufa mun a gurin mu sai da Allah sai mu zo da zaka ta mu sauraron juna mu.
Let's look at this. One of Kaduna's biggest problem is security.
Nene babban matsala ma Kaduna rashin tsaro.
But Kaduna is not the place, the only place where there is the security. There's also insecurity in Zamfara. There's insecurity in Borno. There's insecurity in River State. There are kidnappers in Bayelsa State. There are armed robbers in Delta State. There's insecurity in Lagos. When we come to power, when we are voted into office on February 14th, 2019, we will overhaul the security architecture of this country. I will become a commander in chief that is respected by all the commanders. So that whether it is insecurity in Benue, Plateau, Zamfara, if we ask our commanders to go there and they don't go there, we sanction them immediately.
So that is what I want to do.
The other issue we must resolve immediately is the issue of power, electricity.
So when you perform a gala, you can see the money for the money and you say the money for the money for the money. So
we believe that with electricity, this country is waiting to become the greatest nation in the world. And the northern part of Nigeria is blessed with something that you may not have known, sunshine. We would immediately deploy all resources to build 4.5 megawatts of electricity to arise from solar. We will make sure that there's infrastructure everywhere. As we are building schools, we are building roads, we are building power lines, we are building homes for. We need over 20 million units of houses in this country. So that the Nigerian space can have enough houses, can have enough roads, bridges, for all of us to be able to travel and traverse across Nigeria. How am I going to do it? For every major region in Nigeria, six of them. We are going to make sure that they are connected with the dual carriageway, like better than the one that you see between Abuja and Kaduna. We'll make it 5 lanes each on both sides.
Nigeria, you know, who the patient should have 6 major regions in Nigeria. So when you're the region, and you're the region, partner, you shall allow that to come when the money comes. That will probably book as annual. When the book of book as I am, book as a dual carriageway, road carriageway, the defender, that Abuja Hanyan.
And that train that comes from Abuja to Kaduna, that is working like a snail, we are going to make it very fast. And elsewhere, corruption, as you all have known, the two political parties, the APC and the PDP, they are playing a game now of releasing names of looters on both sides. When I go to the villa next year, I will take the APC list I put on the left pocket, I put the PDP list on the second pocket, I give it to ESCC, they go and settle themselves. So that all the people that have been using our commonwealth, our wealth to build stomach infrastructure instead of real infrastructure, they will spend some time where they need to be. That is not my problem, but their problem. They have already released their
list.
Let me say also on economy. When they talk about economy, they've always deceived you that economies are only based on numbers. I want to create an economy that is based on your own welfare. I want to build a country in which You don't judge the success of your economy based on people with private jets.
The woman has come to tell them as if you wonder. They shall put over, they is a poor, but we don't want to know what you give up, or going to be there at them. Oh, my, and then I put at them the entire end at the beer and then they check. Ah, but she won it.
We are going to ensure that every worker at the federal level.
That would come attach a poor my equity. Poor in my equity at federal level
is not paid a minimum wage but a living wage. Minimum wage is right now 18,000 naira.
Yes. Who would buy it? What the minimum wage in the NASA? So you want to touch your attach you go. But for the come to my what the minimum wage in Bawaita is up to so don't let me gather at it.
But everybody deserves a living wage, 100,000 naira minimum.
That one you can say, you're not 18,000 naira in the IT bad hour, but it's not that thing, but what about the IT government? Four in the NASA, you take it in Nigeria. You have to come out and say that the minimum wage is later to move the heat, which is moving in the
NASA. It is such that, also for those people who are top members, new members,
go. I suppose that NASA, let the woman tell us.
And I want to congratulate those who have passed out today as youth corporate.
And I have to be there.
I'm passing out Barry.
So that's what we are familiar with the government. We must have done when the city of the government here who's going to graduate. I know when I tell us, we're not going to be the government castle. When I do come to the government, we're going to be the
government. You know, when you finish from NYC, they will turn the name of NYC from National Youth Corps Service to now your suffering continues.
So that's why we are putting the putting the NYS. As I did the NYS, go back to that. No question, and the IT and the number show up. I'm buying them from above the value. You can see that over 100,000.
And when you've been, I mean, as a youth corps, you'll be taking home 50,000 naira per month. That is the least amount you pay to you.
No, wow. And you let me the government to do that together, and I think. And you let the woman to that paper that Allah came, you know, you have seen from forward in that youth cover. And it is you have seen forward in youth cover.
If you ask me, how am I going to pay for this? They ask me all the time.
See, I said to them, I got them patients here. I say here, we are one of them.
And when I tell them that we are going to pay, when I tell them how we are going to pay,
I'm not going to get out of here.
They claim that it's going to cause inflation. Inflation. It will make prices of goods and services to be more expensive. But the question you ask yourself is that when one woman is earning $3 billion, did it cause inflation? When our senators and House of Rep people are collecting 13 million naira per month for doing nothing, did it cause inflation? So when they steal, it doesn't cause inflation, but when you want to give support to the masses and the poor in this country, they claim that it causes inflation. It's a lie. Another thing I want to say before I start to wrap up is restructuring. You have been hearing the story about we want to restructure Nigeria. We want state police, we want devolution of power. I don't have a problem with it. But people who have been stealing from Nigeria before cannot restructure Nigeria for you. So I will say to you tonight that I invite you to help us free Nigeria because we are in a digital era and we cannot continue to be led by people with analog mentality.
So in
I would say quickly that I'm very interested in the education. We must send our children to school. And we are not going to do it with politics. Every child deserves education. Whether they are the son of the rich or the daughter of the poor. We are going to declare an emergency in the education sector as soon as we come in next year. It will be a crime not to send your children to school, because education will be free for primary school, secondary school students. So that we will not have kids that are roaming about who they can mobilize to go and cause havoc at the slightest provocation. I want to say one last thing that has brought to my attention, that in northern part of the country, and also the southern part of the country, we have a crisis on our hands, a crisis of drug use. Because of the sadness, the unemployment, and all the bad things that are happening that people cannot cope with, they are now taking all points. Tramadol and the others. But for all these good things we have spoken about, you have to understand that I'm not like them, the rest of them. I am different from them. I have never stolen anybody's money before. I have committed my life for that, for fighting for good governance in this country. And I can tell you that this is a good time to be alive. Because all of us are conscious enough right now. Conscious to know that we have to take back our country. And I want you guys to just rise up before we take questions to say with me, take it back, 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 take it back.
Take it back.
Magana Yakari.
I'm here.
Because of my haircut, I've been around for 30 years. But I have a friend of mine and a colleague and a comrade who has also fought with us on the barricade for as long as I've known him. And that is the Alhaji Yerima Shetima. He just walked in here. He's the president of the Arewa Youth Forum. And when I was coming, I called him and said, Yerima, I'm coming to your town to have a rally. What is your position about Nigeria? He said, look, we are tired. The only qualification we have is not a master's degree. It's not a BSc or even primary school or secondary school certificate. The qualification we have is that we are tired of this nonsense. And we don't want it anymore. So please, before you ask your questions, I just want to give him 2 minutes to address us because he's been my friend for a long time. I cannot let him go without saying something. Thank you, sir.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Good afternoon, my own brother, my own brother. I'll have to die. Let me have that translator. Come over. Well, from Malawi, I'm going to go to the house. Gogor baya tun lokacin mulkin soja muna fafutukan neman demokradiya muna dalibai yana kuma shugaban dalibai a lokacin shi ba a makaranta jama'a university na Lagos ni ma na karatu a Lagos alasu amma a lokacin yana shugaban dalibai ne muna ba ku kohon labari ne babu irin wahalan da bai sha ba a neman kare haƙƙin adama wahala iri tun lokacin soja ba wanda ban gani ba tsakanin kullewa aka ba mu a dikin ba kulle ai wai sabo ba har wani su daga cikin mu daga cikin tana bayan ba ko wanda suke abokan mu ne yau ba su da rai aka shi sa wannan zamani akwai wanda kuma an rufe su akwai wanda kuma an harbe su da bullet har yanzu a cikin su wani sun zama gurawo
mun shedu ne
saboda fafutukan neman demokradiya da yancin Najeriya yau Allah ne wannan rana mai dumbin tarihi zan iya ba da shaida a kansa saboda na dauko dogon tafiya na shekara 25 tare da shi daga lokacin soja har lokacin Obasanjo sai da yaje hijira na san da wannan ya tafi hijira da wuta ta wuta a lokacin soja an samu matsala bayan lokacin soja an samu mulki da aka samu mulki mafi yawan mu da muka yi kokari a lokacin muna dalibai lokacin rigima na Dadeko tsakanin gwamnatin soja da wata kungiya mai suna Dadeko ba irin fafutukan da ba mu yi ba tare har karshenta soja suka bar mulki a yayin da gwamnatin suka bar mulki saka waye gari wasu daga cikin mu muna kanana ba mu da wannan hankali za mu yi tunanin wani mulki wanda su kuma shugabannin mu a lokacin ya kamata sai sun yi amfani da wannan dama a ce an kama duk wani wuri na gwamnati da abubuwan da ke faru a kasar da bai faru ba misali Obasanjo baya ɗaya daga cikin da suka fafi tukan neman demokradiya amma ya ci amfanin aikin da muka yi yau irin su Tinubu irin su Buhari irin su wane da ake magana yau da suke zuwa mulkin Najeriya babu wani daga cikin su da ya fafi tukan neman yanci na demokradiya mu da kuke gani kananan nan a nan muradan shekara 40 da wani abu mu muka yi wannan wahala is on record Kisa za ku yi mamaki kuna ganin muna magana ran muna tashi mun ran muna baci ba ko me yasa haka ba saboda muna ganin mun gulabaita mun ba da rayuwar mu wurin kare haƙƙin bil adama fafutukan neman demokradiya yau an waye gari wa'anda ba su da ilimi fafutukan shugabanci ba su da ilimin shugabanci na gidansu yau sun ne aka samu a senate sun ne aka samu a governor sun ne haske zama shugabannin ƙasa ba su ba da komi ba ba su sadaka da kansu ba yau an waye gari su ne suke mulkin Najeriya da irin waɗannan mutane ba inda zai ku samu nasara a samu canjin yanayi za ku ji mamaki abin da zan gaya muku Sowore akwai abin da Bature ke kira ya stay the stew
saurara saurara
ya saurara da Hausa ya stay the stew
ya ji hakinsa
abin da ce da abin da san ce ya bi hakinsa ba irin wahalan da bai sha ba
bai cuci kuma ba
kuma bai sata ba in fact kun mu wanda yake ba Najeriya a yau ina rika kusan me yake kusan abin da yake kira wani media da yake kira Sahara reporters kusan Sahara reporter kusan irin kun mu wanda Sahara reporter ta yi ma wannan gwamnati na APC kusan kokarin da ta yi ba karamin kokari yayi ba saboda role da social media suka buga ya kai a kashi 100 sun yi kashi 70 na tabbatarwa an kare wata tsohuwar gwamnati a zalima da a kawo wannan canji amma daga cikin waɗanda suka fara kuma shan wuya su ne aka fara kuma wulakantawa kaga abin da ake nema ba cima guri ba kowa ya tabbatar cewa ƙasar nan tana cikin wani halin ko ihawu haka yake zamani ya kai ya kamata ido mai buɗe mu ga yadda za mu yi mu kwato ƙasar mu mu rike saboda mu samu cigaba a rayuwar mu mu ya buɗe wannan kara zaɓe na gaba mu duba cancantan mutane a duba cancantan mutane mu duba wayar da suka sadaukar da rayuwarsu na da samun mulkin demokradiyya wanda suka bada gudunmawa da rayukansu suka yi ƙoƙari su za ku zaɓa zaɓe na gaba magana na ƙarshe ba mu ƙara yadda wani wanda wajen shekara 70 ya ƙara mulkin ƙasar nan analog. It will be suicide. Let me say it in English so that you interpret it in another way before you get down. It will amount to suicide. If we refuse to face realities today and take destiny into our hands, we have to take destiny into our hands. A time has come that we must begin to talk about our own, because this generation belongs to us.
That's right.
If you think you are still young, then you are wasting your time. At the age of 20, 30, 40, it is time. No more tomorrow. Today is the day. either we get it right or we'll lose forever.
That's right.
An attempt to play the usual games of collecting money in the hands of those, our common enemies, and do the wrong thing, posterity will never forgive us.
Physically,
challenge Nigeria. I actually went last week to have a meeting with them last weekend, and I promised that I would do a census of all these physically challenged people of Nigeria, and every one of them, apart from that, we make all our public buildings wheelchair accessible, physically challenged people accessible, that will pay them 50,000 naira per quarter for upkeep. People who are physically challenged will be taken care of. A lot of them are doing so much for this country. In fact, they are the only ones that are winning medals for us in international competitions. So we cannot afford to ignore our physically challenged brothers and sisters. That is my answer. There will be special attention will be paid to them like you've never seen before.
Next question, please.
The next question should get close.
Good evening, everyone. I came all the way from Kaduna to attend this important gathering.
They are distracting now. Are we here for you?
Okay, my question is, you are very good in spending money, but you have not raised a concern. How are you going to generate money? More especially by considering that the petroleum that we are claiming we have is no longer is going. But can't you think of how you can diversify our economy? And then you say you are going to pay 100,000 naira as a living wages for every Nigeria. Nigeria, as of now, we have 198 million people.
No, 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 not every Nigeria. Nigerian workers.
Okay, Nigerian workers. Okay. Okay, thank you. Answer the question.
Next question.
Great research. I am here in support of Sowere, the president of 2019. I am here in support of him with all the detach in Nigeria because I am their member. I am a coordinator from Sangha Local Government. My name are Comrade Ajamu Deborah. I am here to tell us all not to give him questions because I know he is capable and he will be able to do all. Why? Because of his age. Sowore, I am here to give you my support and every other person. If I have my right, I will use all my thumbs and my fingers to vote you. And I want to say this. If you are here and you want Sowore to be in the presidency, you have to go and get your PVC. You cannot be here making noise. That is what I have to say. I rest my case.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Regina Samuel Awell. I work with Federal Radio Corporation of Nigeria. Yes, sir. My question is, most of we've been seeing different presidential
declarations.
Yes. When they come, exactly what you mentioned. That is what they mentioned. All the promises, that's what they promised. Everything you said, that's what they want to say.
What is different?
What makes you different from them? Because we may not know until when they come in that we not start seeing changes. So please, sir, explain briefly for us. Let us know the difference between you now and those that.
One last question.
I have a question, a request I want here. The question personally has been answered by you in the issue of unemployment. I'm going by your question, please. I know you're a manager and everything. You are successful in business, and I'm very sure you can handle Nigeria. Now my request is, will you be willing to pen that resignation letter if all you promise will not become in confusion in 2 years? Should we impeach you or hand over that letter?
You hand over that letter to make the attorney general if what you promise. In 2 years, you are not able to do anything as it is. My fear is this struggle is for sacrifice for the youth. And we have the likes of Ahmed Buhari, we have Dudu Toye, we have Kingsley, all coming out on yourself. Please, can we have a round table agreement and consensus where one of you will come for the struggle, for the youth, and please sacrifice for us? Please. That's right.
Thank you. I'm going to try and speak very loud. My voice is very loud. But I know this is one of the biggest problems we are facing. No electricity. You can imagine an event as important as this. We don't have light to even enjoy our voices. I'll say very quickly, the question about generation of revenue, I will answer it in a very direct way. What has been happening to Nigeria is that when we generate revenue, thieves steal them and take them away. I am never going to allow that to happen. Let me explain something to you very quickly. This year, let me just address this very quickly. This year, and I want you to listen to me, the person who asked about generation of revenue. This year alone, the federal government announced that the federal inland revenue service generated almost 2 to 3 trillion naira. They said that customs generated almost 2 trillion naira. That's 5 trillion naira. Even jam generated over 17 billion naira. ESCC recovered 700 billion naira. Nigeria Port Authority generated almost 1.7 trillion naira. What is the budget of Nigeria? 8 trillion naira. Already, without going to the NNPC, we have already generated our budget. But you know that the thieves in Abuja, they are just stealing the money. The grass cutters. We've gotten to a point now that our monkeys have no banana to eat. They are now eating naira.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
Snakes are swallowing money. Up and down. Because there's too much money in Nigeria. So revenue is not the problem. What we will do is to ensure that we increase our tax base. Right now, according to the federal government, only 130,000 Nigerians are paying taxes. Whereas we can have all these millionaires have been paying their taxes so that we can have money for public service. Or public services. That needs to go to people who have physical challenges, our mothers who go to hospital to deliver. We can have money to build schools and send children to school. We can have money to construct roads, bridges. By now, we should be building the third Niger Bridge in the southeast. By now, we should have another road that links Kaduna to Kano without let or hindrance. We should have roads around this country. We should have fast trains. Morocco just had the fastest train running a few weeks ago. Why can't Nigeria? Even if we cannot make Nigeria look like a United Kingdom. Or America, where I've lived for 19 years, at least we can make Nigeria look like Ghana.
Better.
Right? Better. So that if you go to Ghana today, I urge you to travel to Ghana, even if it is once before you die. And go and see that electricity does not blink in Ghana. Where do Ghanaians get electricity at Nigeria? So that the question you should challenge yourself with. And I want to urge you, because we don't have a lot of time tonight. We are going to do online virtual town hall meeting soon. And you can ask even more questions. And as you can tell, we have been traveling a lot. But if you can do this for me, and you can do this for yourself, please,
don't be asking anybody why you're not going for councillor. There are thousands of councillorship positions. You go and take that councillorship position. Don't ask anybody why you're not going for senate. Bukola Saraki is not better than any one of you. He's a senator. Dino Medaye is not better than any one of you. He's a senator. Go and contest for senate. You can go and become a House of Rep member. In fact, you can become the president of the Federal Republic of Nigeria if you are not complacent. Sit up, stand up, and take your rightful place in Nigeria. Stop collecting 500 naira. Stop collecting water. Stop collecting branded rice that they use to put your future in jeopardy. That is what they use to detain your future. And when you are sick, you don't have hospitals to go to. If you go to hospital, the doctors can only give you advice. And if you go there 3 days, they say it's malaria. After 3-4 days or 8 days, they will convert it to typhoid. And if you are not cured after, they will send you out of the hospital to go to church or mosque. You can cure yourself. Nigeria can be a better place, my brothers and sisters. Nigeria can be one of the greatest countries in the world. But you must have a person of integrity, a honest person, somebody you can trust to take care of the country. Because that is the question somebody asked me. How are you different? The fact is that I'm 47 years old. I have never held public office before. And sometimes people will say, that is inexperience. No! The people that are running this country, the only experience they have is the experience of stealing. That is not the kind of experience I have. I've had experience fighting for the betterment of Nigeria for 30 years. I have never stolen my child from anybody before. I have never taken somebody's goods. I have never given money to snakes or monkeys to swallow before. I have never partaken in the assassination of another person. I have never sponsored talk to beat up anyone. Instead, I have been the one that has been at the receiving end of a brutal state, Nigerian state. But right now, this is very important. We are approaching promised land. Please do not look back. We are approaching promised land. Please do not look back. Kaduna, it is going to happen. If we join hands together, we will no longer even need to print posters. We won't need to be doing everything that we are doing. We've got to look at ourselves. We inaugurated into power from May 29, 2019. I appreciate that question. I would love Kingsley, based on his records, to be my central bank governor. Yes, I would love Fela Kuroje to be the Minister of Information. He's very good at acquiring information. I would love all these great young men to work with me. But what I do at least now is a strong person who is not afraid of anybody. I will sit down with anybody. I am sitting down with you. They are not more important than you. I am the only person among the young people who has entered Northern Nigeria. Some of them, and I'm telling you, some of them are afraid to enter the North because they think that the North, they eat people when they enter the North. I have been to Kano today by road. I am in Kaduna and you have not eaten me. And if you want to eat, come and eat me. Are not cannibals. You are Nigerians, you are suffering like people in the South. Yes, all of us are suffering, and nobody should be afraid of Kaduna, nobody should be afraid of Kano. This every inch of this country must be free, and I'm willing to do it. If I need to have to go to Sambisa Forest to campaign, I will go and campaign there. Yes. If I need to go to Dapchi, I will go there. If I need to go to Umunede, I will go there. Because all of us are Nigerians and are looking for a better future. And I want to be the person that will lead that future for you. You are mentioning them. Have you seen them in Kaduna? Have you seen them in Kano? Most of them are on the internet. I'm on the internet too, but I also hear them on the ground. Go back, Kaba. Gaskiani, Hakana Yakari.
Thank you very much. Yes, I'm sorry. There are other questions. This is open. I'm sure I'm
2 weeks time. That's how it works. But I won't have it for that time. That's how I am. They don't have to do that. They don't have to fire away. Who got it? That's how it works. They need to attend to the case. As a result of time, we will not be able to attend to the case. But one thing is that 2 weeks time, that's how it works.
All this was, that's so much love.